listen to shoot the defence. It's unbelievable, Jeff.
Welcome to Shoot the Defence on FNX, brought to you by Mysportswear, Youth Energy Drinks and Save Association, aiming to effect positive change in safeguarding and victim engagement. I'm your host, Stel, and on this edition, I had the absolute pleasure of being joined by former Olympiakos and Bolton midfielder Stelios Giannakopoulos. Now, as you guys know, Stelios was in the Greece Euro 2004 championship-winning squad. He played the key role in the qualifiers, was a fantastic squad rotation player, and I'm pretty sure you'll enjoy this interview as much as I enjoyed talking to Stelios. So, Stelios, thank you for joining me on Shoot the Defence. Great to have you on. How are you?
Thanks for inviting me. I'm fine. I'm having my vacation time now in Paros Island, in Greece. Fantastic.
Very fantastic nice. Weather. Very yeah. Nice. How was your birthday?
My birthday was brilliant. I had a nice and quiet dinner with my family, some friends, and it was great.
So, Stelios, your first season at Olympiakos was a huge success. Club ran away with the championship. The things I vaguely remember it being a fairly balanced squad age-wise. You had a lot of young players, a lot of experienced players. Tell us a bit about the squad and the season as a whole.
Yes, it was a very good team. It was boasting from with talent and the ambition from all the players, especially the Greek players were very, very young, excited to succeed in our career, and with some quality additions from foreign players like Predrag Djordjevic, Ilija Ivic, Sinis Agogic, and Refik Sabanazovic. In the beginning, we managed to get together and make a very, very strong and powerful team that dominated in that era.
As you're well aware, you won a title in every season as an Olympiakos player, and there are no doubts about you being a club legend. But there are two particular moments that actually stand out in supporters' minds. There was the 40-metre half volley against Porto, and the two goals in the 3-0 win over Panathinaikos in 2003, which effectively sealed the title. Now, talk us through the Porto goal. Did you get a bit of luck with your first touch?
Yeah, it wasn't the best of touches, my first touch, but I found myself lucky enough to see the ball bouncing just in front of my right foot, and it was a perfect timing for me to try and volley the ball. Obviously, you need a little bit of composure, and of course, you need a little bit of luck to hit the target and score a magnificent goal, because it was really, really far. It was not an easy shoot to make.
Absolutely.
But finally, I managed to hit the target and obviously create history, because that goal has left a huge mark in my career, and of course I still remember it. All the Olympiakos fans remember it, and it was the opener in the Champions League, the new Champions League history from the genesis from the UEFA Cups. You know, it was the first Champions League goal for Olympiakos.
Can you describe the rivalry between Olympiakos and Panathinaikos? I don't think people realise how intense this rivalry is.
Right, it's a Greek, the Greek derby. It's the two biggest teams in Greece. By tradition, traditionally, Olympiakos and Panathinaikos is the biggest game in Greece. So, scoring and leaving your mark in these games remains forever, you know, in your career, and in the history of the Clásicos, the Greek Clásicos.
Tell me, how did your transfer to Bolton come about? Did you know much about the club?
Of course I did. Of course I knew it was running for the last five months of my contract. It was expiring in June of 2003 with Olympiakos. I was a free agent. So my Greek agent had put on the table a very, very attractive offer from Bolton Wanderers, which was not the Bolton Wanderers that we created a couple of years later, but get promoted in Europe, etc., etc. You know, it was an interesting offer from Premier League, and it was very, very, you know, for me it was a very, very big challenge to move to the Premier League. So that was the history.
What was it like playing for Big Sam? Because as I understand, he was very, very into his sports science. He's not your stereotypical British manager.
Well, he's every manager that I have worked with, either Greece or England or the national team. You know, every manager is different. Every manager has his own personality in and out of the pitch. So this is the same situation with Big Sam. You know, he's a very demanding manager. He pays attention to the detail, and especially his backroom staff are very, very highly educated in every department: science department, physical department, psychological preparation. Everybody was very, very high qualified. That's why we managed to get success in the club.
What would you say was your favourite moment at Bolton?
My favourite moment? Mm. My favourite moments were playing in Europe. Because nobody had ever dreamt before in the club, especially the fans of the club that are very, very loyal, obviously. Nobody expected from us to get qualified for Europe, and especially make it twice. So these memories are very, very emotional memories for me, and I think not only for me, for all the family of the club, the fans, the players, the staff. Everybody enjoyed these days.
Now, Bolton clearly has a big place in your heart. In fact, I remember seeing an image of your son wearing the Bolton kit before the Euro 2004 semi-final against the Czechs. While we're on the subject of the Euros, no one gave Greece a chance, did they? I think Latvia were the longest favourites, Greece being second. How far did you guys think you could go prior to the tournament?
Yeah, we've said many, many times, because we have given a lot of interviews about this one, about 2004, and the answer is always the same. You know, we went there to enjoy the tournament, to try to get as success as possible, at least win a game or scoring goals, and leave behind a positive mark.
Absolutely.
That was the target, the initial target from the national team. But of course later, you know, everybody saw that we had a very, very strong team. We were a team with capital letters, with very, very strong bonds, each other. We believed it. And game after game, you know, the confidence in the footballer gets bigger and bigger. And finally we made it. But it was not an easy task for us.
I hear you're currently head coach of third division side Kifisia.
Yes, I have started my managerial career. I have already worked in two teams in the third division in Greece. And I think now it's time for me to move on to move forward and experience a high level of coaching opportunities and try to lift myself up as I did as a player. I'd like to do it as a manager too.
Are you planning on coaching a bigger club in Greece or coaching abroad?
You know, I don't have a problem with that. You know, it's quality what I'm after, and whatever quality and potential clubs come in my way, of course I will discuss about it and try to do the best for my career.
Okay, Stelios, I've got some questions from the Facebook group page. The first one is from Ryan. He asks, how's the future of the Greek national team looking, in your opinion? Are the young players being given a fair opportunity?
No, I think we are back on track now. After the couple of years ago when we had a very, very bad run, a terrible run of games. We weren't performing well at all. But I think now we are back on track and we are ready to go.
Craig asks, whose decision was it to change the name on the shirt from your surname to your first name?
It was my decision because, you know, I saw that all the English fans, it was very, very difficult for them to pronounce my surname, Giannakopoulos, which is easy for us. We are Greek, but for the English people it's not so easy. That's why I put Stelios on the shirt. It's much easier to pronounce, and it was nice.
And on a final note, Nicholas asks, why do so few Greek players come to play in England?
That's an interesting question. To be honest, I don't know. I don't think we are not good enough, because we have talent. We have talented players, and I think the Greek players deserve a chance in the English Premiership, or at least in the Championship. You know, we have talented players. They play in a big clubs in Europe. And I think they deserve a chance to the Premier League too.
Fantastic. Well, Stelios, thank you ever so much for your time. Really appreciate it. Hopefully we can talk again soon on the show.
Well, it was my pleasure. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much. Well, you have a good evening. I'll speak to you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.